Good day, everyone. So for today's video, we're going to discuss something about exponential equation. But before that, what are exponential expressions first? So paano nga po ba natin madedetermine that a certain expression is exponential in nature? So let us consider these two expressions. We have down here x squared at saka si 2 raised to x. So which among them is considered to be exponential expression? Okay, so si exponential expression po dito ay si 2 raised to x. Why? Exponential expression are those expression to which yung exponent niya ay merong variable. Okay po? So this is, ito pong isa naman na to, si x squared. This is just simply an expression, but si 2 raised to x is considered to be an exponential expression. Okay po? Again, exponential expressions are those expressions kung saan ang exponent niya ay merong variable. Okay po? So, let us now try or let us discuss how do we solve exponential equations. So, we solve exponential equations in three easy steps. Number one is that for us to make the bases of both sides the same. So, kailangan po yung base ng parehong sides ng equation mo ay pareho. Second is for us to eliminate the bases, and then we have to solve for the unknown. So after eliminating the bases, ang i-consider lang natin would be the exponents, and then we simply solve for the unknown. So for it to be more clear to you, let us have an example. Suppose we have down there 4 raised to x equals 4 cubed. Okay po? So dun sa steps na discussed natin a while ago on the previous slide, the first step is for us to make the bases of both sides of the equations the same. So, we have here two expressions, si 4 raised to x at saka si 4 cubed. Now, alin po ba dito yung bases na tinatawag natin? Yung bases na tinatawag natin is actually etong dalawang 4. Okay? At kailangan, pareho po daw po tayo ng bases. So, let us ask ourselves, pareho na po ba ng base? Okay, since pareho na po siya ng base, then we'll proceed to our next step, and that is for us to eliminate the bases. And for us to eliminate the bases, just crush out the bases, and then you just write the exponents here, and that is x equals 3. Okay po? And since pag pumunta tayo sa last step, and that is for us to solve for the unknown, and since it already says here that x equals 3, then the value of x or the value of the unknown for this certain problem is equal to 3. Okay po? So hence, our value of x or value of the unknown or the answer for this problem is 3. And for us to check that, so let us check that. What we're going to do with the value of x is for us to substitute into the original equation, and that is 4 raised to x equals 4 cubed. And then, again, what we're going to do is to substitute the value of x. So, this is 3 equals 4 cubed. So, dito pa lang, we can say that both sides of the equations are equal. Hence, our value of the unknown is correct. Okay po? So, let us make it more challenging this time. Suppose we have here 5 raised to negative x minus 1 equals 25 raised to 2x minus 3. So let me rewrite the exponential equation, that is 5 raised to negative x minus 1 equals 25 raised to 2x minus 3. So if you kung mapapansin natin, ang exponent natin ay si x negative x minus 1 at saka si 2x minus 3. Okay po? Going back to our first step, dun sa previous slide natin kanina, our first step is for us to make the bases of both sides of the equations the same. So, what are the bases? Ano po ba yung bases natin? That is 5 and 25. So, paano po natin magagawa na pareho yung base ng ating both sides of the equation? Okay po? So, think of a number to which pwede natin i-represent si 25 na kung saan ang base niya ay 5. Okay po? Since yun lang po yung only way para maging magkapareho sila ng bases. Okay po? So, we will rewrite the first side of the, or the, the first side of the equation, that is 5 raised to negative x minus 1 equals, and what we're going to do is to represent 25 kung saan ang base niya din ay 5. So paano po ba natin ma-represent si 25 kung saan ang base natin ay 5. Okay? So we all know that 25 is equal to 5 squared, or if you multiply 5 by itself, that is 25. Hence, we can represent 25 as 5 squared. Okay po? And then, si 25 or si 5 squared ay naka-raise kay 2x minus 3. Okay po? And by the rule of the law, or by the laws of exponent, to simplify this, we would have 5 raised to negative x minus 1 equals, so since dito, kung mapapansin natin, this is actually a base to where it is raised by an exponent and then raised to another exponent. At kapag meron po tayong ganitong problem, what we're going to do with our exponent is for us to multiply this. So we have 2 times 2x, that is 4x. So we will have 5 raised to 4x, and then we have here 2 times negative 3, that would be negative 6. Okay po? And at this point, we have now what? We have now two bases to which two expressions to which the bases are the same. Okay po? So pareho na po tayo ng base, which is 5, so we can just cancel this out. Okay? And then we have to just consider all the exponents. So that is negative x minus 1 equals 4x minus 6. Okay po? And for us to solve for the unknown, ang gagawin po natin, lahat ng may variable x sa kabilang side ng equation at lahat naman ng walang variable ay sa kabilang side ng equation. So matitira dito si negative x. So we have negative x, and then we will transpose 4x to the other side of the equation. So magiging negative 4x. And then equals, so ang matitira dito is si negative 6, at ililipat natin si negative 1 sa kabilang side ng equation, which will make it positive 1. So we have plus 1. And by this, we can now simplify this. So we have negative x minus 4x. That is simply saying negative 1 minus 4. So that is negative 5x equals. And then we have negative 6 plus 1. So we'll be have, it's just like saying, meron kang utang na 6, pero meron kang piso. Then, simply saying that is positive or negative 5. And since, kukunin lang naman natin yung value ni x, para makuha yung value ni x at para matanggal yung negative 5 natin dito, what we're going to do is to divide both sides by negative 5. Hence, the value of our x would be what? The value of x would be negative 5 times negative 5, or divided by negative 5, sorry, that would be positive 1. Hence, the value of our x, or the value of the unknown, is positive 1. And if we're going to check that, we'll be having, so, ang gagawin lang natin is just to substitute it to the original equation, that is 5 raised to, so we have here 5 raised to negative x minus 1 equals 25 raised to what? Raised to 2x minus 3. So we'll be having 5 raised to negative what? That is negative 1. That is negative 1 minus 1 equals to 25 times, or raised to 2 times 1 minus 3. And by simplifying this, we have 5 raised to, so negative 1 minus 1, that's negative 2, equals 25 raised to what? That is 2 minus 3. And then we'll be having 5 raised to negative 2 equals to 25 raised to negative 1. And if we're going to simplify this, kapag sinabi natin 5 raised to negative 2, we can simplify that. Para maging positive exponent natin, we just reciprocate it, or we reciprocate the base. We'll be having 1 over 5 square. That is 1 over 5 square equals what? Same case dito kay 25 raised to negative 1. We'll be having what? 1 over 25 raised to 1. And if we're going to simplify that, we'll be having 1 over 25 equals 1 over 25. Hence, the value of our x is correct. So, pinakita lang po natin that our value of x is correct. Okay po? So, that's how we solve our exponential equation. So, let us have another example. So, let us have here 64 raised to x minus 4 equals 16 raised to x minus 3. So, punta po ulit tayo kay first step. At ang gagawin natin is for us to make the bases the same. So, thinking of 64, ano po kaya yung pwede nating gawing base kung saan or ano po kaya yung magiging base natin na pareho si 64 at saka si 16. So, kung mapapansin natin, we can actually represent 64 as 4 times 4 times 4, or we can have 4 cubed. And so, with 16, we can actually what? We can actually represent this as 4 times 4 or 4 squared. So, hence, pwede natin itong gamitin para maging magkapareho or maging magkapareho yung kanyang base. So, we'll be having, so i-represent natin si 64 as 4 cubed. So, that is 4 cubed. Since si 64 ay naka-raise kay x minus 4, so i-raise pa rin natin siya kay x minus 4, equals, so si 16 po, kanina, is that is 4 squared, so we have 16, which is equivalent to 4 squared, ay naka-raise po kay x minus 3. Okay? And by the rule of, the law of exponent, we will simplify this by what? By multiplying 3 to x and 3 to negative 4, and so with 2 to x and 2 to negative 3. Hence, we'll be having 4 raised to 3x minus what? Minus 12 equals to 4 raised to 2x minus 6. Okay po? And since pareho na po tayo ng base, we can just eliminate the bases and consider just the exponent. So, we'll be having 3x minus 12 equals 2x minus 6. And what we're going to do is, ilalagay natin lahat ng may variable x sa kabilang side ng equation at lahat ng wala sa kabilang side. Hence, ang matitira dito would be 3x at isasama natin si 2x, which will be transposed to the other side of the equation, making it negative 2x equals negative 6 ang natira sa kabila, at si negative 12 naman, si negative 12 naman, itatranspose naman natin sa kabila, making it positive 12. And by simplifying this, we have 3x minus 2x, that is simply x, equals negative 6 plus 12, that is simply positive 6. Hence, the value of our x is 6. And ayun po yung magiging solution natin sa ating exponential equation. Okay po? So, let us proceed with our last example. Let's make it a little bit challenging this time. Suppose we have 1 half. So, let me just rewrite it. That is 1 half raised to negative 3x equals 32 raised to x minus 2. Okay po? So, challenging siya in a way that meron tayong fraction at meron din tayong whole number na base. Okay po, so paano po kaya natin magagawang magkapareho po yung base nila? Okay? By the law of exponent, to which if we have a negative exponent, then we can simplify it by reciprocating the whole expression at magiging positive po yung ating exponent, which is equivalent to 1 over a raised to m. Okay po? And since si 1 half po ay fraction, or 1 half can be rewritten as 1 half raised to 1, to which the exponent of 2 is 1. Okay? And by reversing the process of our law of exponent, then we can represent 1 half as 2 raised to negative 1. Okay po? So, pwede po natin gawin yun. But, and since alam natin that 32 can be what? Can be rewritten to which its base is 2. Okay po? So, pwede natin siyang isulat kung saan ang base niya ay 2. Okay po? So, we'll be having si 1 half po natin, pwede po natin siyang i-represent as 2 raised to negative 1. So, we'll be having what? We'd be having 2 raised to negative 1 raised to negative 3. So, nirepresent lang po natin si 1 half as 2 raised to negative 1 equals. So, paano po natin i-represent si 32 na ang base niya ay 2? So, by thinking of the factors of 32, that would be having, that's 2 times 2, that's 4, times 2, that's 8, that's times 2, that's 16, and times 2, that's 32. So, we can represent 32 as what? We can represent 32 as 2 raised to 5. So, since 5 beses natin multiply si 2 to get 32. Okay po? And then, we all know that 32 ay naka-raise kay x minus 2. Okay po? And in this juncture, or in this moment, alam na natin that we already have the same bases. Okay, but we cannot cancel it yet pa because hindi pa natin si-simplify yung ating exponent. So, we'll be having what? We simplify the exponent by multiplying this negative 1 to negative 3x and then 5 to x, and then 5 to negative 2. So, ang mangyayari would be having 2 raised to what? Negative 1 times negative 3, that's positive 3x, equals, that's 2 raised to 5 times x, that's 5x, and then 5 times negative 2, that is negative 10. Okay po? And with this, alam na po natin that we already have the same bases, then we can eliminate the bases, and then, we just consider the exponent. So, we have 3x equals 5x minus 10. And for us to solve for the unknown, that is our last step, then, ang gagawin natin lahat ng may x ay sa kabilang side ng equation, at lahat naman ng wala ay sa kabilang side. Meaning, si 3x, ang makakasama niya sa kabilang side ay si 5x, to which kapag tinranspose natin siya sa kabila, that becomes negative 5x. And then equals, ang matitira sa kabilang side ng equation ay negative 10. And by simplifying this, 3x minus 5x, that is negative 2x, equals negative 10. And since x lang naman po yung hinahanap natin, then para mawala or ma-eliminate natin yung negative 2, then we divide both sides by negative 2, making one side of the equation equal to x. So, that is x equals what? Negative 10 divided by negative 2, that is positive 5. Hence, the value of our unknown for this equation is positive 5. And that's how we solve exponential equation.